Hi, my name is Chrissy Gasty. I'm the founder of BioBuddy. I'm also a graduate student at Ohio State. I live in Columbus, Ohio with my wife and two dogs. So BioBuddy's founding story is kind of strange, but so I was serving in the Army in the 75th Ranger Regiment as a medic, and I loved my job and kind of fell in love with medicine and decided I wanted to become a physician. So in order to do that, you got to take the prerequisites for medical school. So I left the Army in 2020 to attend University of Virginia to take what's called a post-bac pre-med program, where if you already have your degree but you don't have the prerequisites, you take all the prereqs for med school in a year. So it was really challenging. And then to compound that, this was during COVID. So all of that, you know, all that tough coursework was being delivered remotely via Zoom. So what I experienced is probably what many learners experienced during the pandemic, which was, you know, professors, teachers, administrators doing the best they could, trying to deliver information. But I thought it could be improved on. And what I really wanted was a high quality version of a textbook that could be delivered online, something like a Netflix for education. So as I was applying to medical schools, I couldn't get this thought out of my head about creating a online high quality education company that could be delivered to anybody with an internet access. And so I thought about it and thought about it. And we selected biology to be our first subject because so much of biology is at the microscopic level and requires high quality visual aids. And I started researching, okay, we're gonna need some PhDs, we're gonna need some animators, some software developers. So that's when I found out about SciAni, and the relationship's been wonderful. So I just Googled science animation, and a few clicks, I saw some other competitors, but it was clear that SciAni was the, you know, the industry leader, just looking at all the partners they've worked with in the past and seeing the, you know, stunning animation that was on their website. Set up a call, and then we budgeted out a prototype, which would, you know, we're going to buy 20 minutes of animation to cover one unit of AP biology, which we then turned into an hour's worth of produced videos. And we were so happy with the work SciAni did. It turned into a long-term partnership. And this was during the pandemic. So all that in-person instruction I was hoping to get was remotely delivered on Zoom. And I really struggled with it. And I'm not a good reader. I'm a visual learner. So just having a textbook and Zoom lectures was really challenging for me. And that's kind of how I noticed the need for animation. And then me, while I reflected when I was taking these courses that, you know, how challenging it must be for, you know, younger kids, students without means, you know, what kind of struggles they would be having with remote learning. Because prior to joining the Army, I was actually a substitute teacher in high poverty schools. And I know how challenging learning is in those environments in person. And then I could only think how hard it would be for those students to be doing it remotely. So that was a big motivator for me too when choosing to start BioBuddy. It started with, you know, my little team of graduate students, PhDs, another partner of ours who've done a fantastic job. We collaborated to write scripts in a Word document, and we pushed that over to SciAni, and they, you know, they put together a storyboard with just imagery from the internet, and they say, we'll refine this into our own original animation, but this is what we're thinking. And so each step of the process, we would have to approve and refine the input there. So it was a really collaborative effort between SciAni, the graduate students that we hired, and myself to approve this process. And so after the storyboarding, we got an original storyboard from SciAni with their own artwork, and then it turned into what we called the rough animation, which was the first look at the actual moving pieces. And SciAni was great because they took all the feedback we wanted in each one of these phases and refined until we were, you know, happy with the product, which, you know, they were efficient, they were on time, and we have, you know, nothing but good things to say about the quality of the animation. And after we got that animation back, we budgeted 20 minutes of animation per hour's worth of content. And we have one of our on-screen instructor, she's wonderful. She's a biology PhD candidate at the University of Virginia. She's our on-screen instructor. So we take that original script that's been approved by these PhD experts, and we work with a production company to shoot her on a green screen, and then we overlay it with the animation to, you know, when animation is required, we provide the animation, and then when it's better to have an on-screen instructor with a bulleted list, that's what we have. So our content is, it's turned into 7 hours of animated lecture videos with a, you know, a wonderful presenter that covers every topic in the AP curriculum. So what we've been able to build by collaborating with SciAni is a modern version of a textbook. I think 65% of learners are visual learners, so we think we're about to tap into a market there and help learners that traditionally struggle with these hard scientific topics. Yeah, so once we completed, we tested the product throughout the development. So initially, I think September of 22, we had had our prototype developed, that 1 hour of content that I described. And the first thing we did was we got some former pre-med students to watch these videos, and they loved them. They gave us great feedback. So that initial feedback was, okay, we really do want to go all in here and develop an entire biology curriculum. What they also mentioned was they wanted more than just videos. So we developed a customizable Q&A study tool where students can select the topics they want to study, generate a test, and when they get the response, there's a still image of the science, the SciAni animation. But we also have a tutor walkthrough feature where each question, which we have hundreds of, a student can test their knowledge, read about the answer, and then also select a video tutor walkthrough where the tutor, one of our PhDs, will walk you through how to solve the problem. So even if you get the question right, but you're a little iffy on it, you can watch our PhD, Hope, walk you through it. So that's a wonderful feature that I intuitively wanted as a student. And then when we tested that again later on as we were developing, the students loved it again. So that initial feedback drove us to, one, build out an entire 7 hours of animated lecture videos, and then add a new feature, which is comprehensive Q&A. And then once we had developed our go-to-market product, we tested that in a pilot market here in Ohio. And we had 27 students at Ohio State take a look at it and interact with it and give us their feedback. And they were really impressed. We learned a lot. So they thought it was an efficient tool. They thought the animation was engaging. They really enjoyed the product. So we were really happy with the product we built. And as we spoke to students, you know, we kind of learned what their pain points were. One of them being that, you know, it's, you know, they have so many other things that they have to pay for, And so what we've decided to do for our nationwide, or you can even say worldwide launch that we've just done in the past couple of weeks, is we're going to keep BioBuddy free of cost for this school year so that we can prove our worth to educators, students, parents, and everybody in our ecosystem that we really are the pinnacle of, you know, biology resources. So we tailored our curriculum to the AP, which in I think AP is a global product, but it's very common in the United States. So AP, Advanced Placement, it transfers to college credit. So typically high schoolers take the exam, and then if they score a 3 out of 5 or above, most colleges accept that as college credit. So it transfers well to undergraduate university students, because if you're a pre-med student, for instance, you're going to have to take typically 8 hours of biology spread across 2 semesters. And that typically 90% of that at most universities is covered by the AP curriculum. So we decided to choose AP because it's a nice or organized, standardized curriculum that really does teach you everything you need to know about, you know, the fundamentals of biology. So we have 8 units, everything from cell structure and function to ecology. So this year, our plan is to grow the word of mouth about BioBuddy. So we want to get, we've already started generating users, by the way, so we're really happy with the first few weeks of our launch. And we can see what students are doing on there, and they're actually engaging with, you know, I'd say about 40% of those who sign up are watching videos, interacting with the Q&A. So that's nice feedback there. But to answer your question, this year, we plan on expanding even more offerings within our biology curriculum. We've got a fun project that we plan on doing this year with SciAni that's going to help tactile learners. So it's kind of like an interactive animation that students can zoom in, interact with the animation, hear a narration about what's going on there. So I won't spoil it because we still have to develop it, but we're really excited about it. And then in the future, we are planning on expanding to other subjects. We're not welded to this idea, but we would love to become the platform that hosts everything a STEM student would need on one platform. And so I think in the future, we'd like to expand out to chemistry, physics, environmental science. But we're going to wait to see what the students want, and we'll collaborate with SciAni and our other partners to make that happen. Specifically, yeah, I'll just say that I worked with Sam and Al for probably 18 months. Every week we would check in, and they were, you know, the most professional and flexible partners I could ask for, and they did an incredible job. I actually miss our Friday calls now because we finished all of our product development with SciAni for the time being, and I'm really excited to get back to work with Sam and Al because they're really incredible. I would recommend SciAni to anyone in the science community that is trying to efficiently and effectively deliver a message. That could be someone who's a researcher, someone who's developing pharmaceuticals, anything. If you're trying to explain at any level how something scientifically is working, I would definitely recommend using SciAni. You know, I really can't recommend them enough. They've done such a wonderful job. I really lucked out that we didn't have to do trial and error with multiple animation firms or try and do some, you know, freelance thing. It really, everything I read about SciAni when I came to their website 2 years ago has, has turned out to be true. And, you know, I cannot recommend them enough, their professionalism and the content that they provide. And we're extremely lucky to have them on board as a partner going forward.